Let us pray.
Father, we thank you for the privilege of coming before you to be taught by your Spirit.
We
thank you because your word is life and spirit. And we know that as the word enters in, you'll quicken us in the inner man. We pray, O Lord, that every one of us will receive your teaching today from your word in Jesus' name. Help us so that our hearts will be open to you and to your word. And the blessing and profit of the word will be ours in Jesus' name. Anoint the words that come out, anoint our ears hearing, and let the blessing enrich our lives and our families and the whole church in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. We have another period of a profitable study as we come together today. We're still in Hebrews chapter 13. You will see that chapter 13 deals with practical subjects for us as members of the church, as individual believers to consider. In the study we had last week, we had encouragement from the Lord.
It
reminds us of his companionship. And that should bring confidence in the heart of the believer. In fact, that promise of the Lord of his divine companionship gives us encouragement so that we can believe as a child of God or as children of God that all the promises of God will be ours.
Lotito awon ileri Olorun gege bi alabarin papo wa ati o fi wa lokan bale wi pe a le gba awon ileri na gbo a si le ma rin nitimotimo pelu Olorun.
And it is that confidence that gives us the positive confession saying, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear what man shall do unto me.
Awon ileri yi o lo si fi wa lokan bale lo mu wa lokan le lati le ma jewo igbagbo wa ni ona to dara wi pe Oluwa ni Oluranlowo mi eru ta ni o ba mi.
Since your helper is none other than the Almighty, there is no evil, there is no harm that can possibly befall you. The abiding presence of the Lord ensures the supply of every need and guarantees all sufficient help.
Iwa pelu eni Oluwa o fun wa ni idaniloju nipa ipese fun gbogbo aini wa ati pelu fifini wa lokan bale nipa tito iranlowo wa.
But then as we look at what the Lord is doing,
bi ati wa nwo nti Oluwa nse yi,
and we look at what the Lord has done,
ki ata si ranti ohun ti Oluwa ti se
fun wa, and we're meditating upon what the Lord will still do,
ti a si sasaro ninu okan wa nipa ohun ti Olorun yo tun se,
we become so grateful to the Lord as we're counting our blessings.
Awa ni okan imore si Oluwa bi ati nka awon ibuko wa lokan
okan. Then wondering how we can we love God back, how can we reciprocate what he has done for us, how can we fully appreciate the things he has done for us. And the apostle, the inspired writer, is telling us in the verses we're going to study, he says, because of what he has done for us, because of his divine companionship, because of the all-sufficient supply is going to give unto us, this is the duty and this is the responsibility of every believer.
Nipa nitori ohun ti Olorun ti se fun wa yi o ni onkowe yi nipa imi si Olorun nipa ti o nko iwe o wa so fun wa wi pe o gbodo ni mo gba ta ti jowo ara wa fun Oluwa ta ti feran re Olorun wa fun wa ni ojuse aigbodo ma se kan ni bi ati tun tesiwaju nu eko na.
Look at what he tells us in verses 7, 8 and 9.
Iwo wa wo to so fun wa ni ese ikeje ikejo ati ikesan.
He says, remember them which have the rule over you, who have spoken unto you the word of God, whose faith follow concerning the end of their conversation.
Oni e ma ranti awon ti won je olori yin ti won si soro Olorun fun yin ki e ma ro opin ro iwaye won ki e si ma se afarawe igbagbo won.
But say Jesus Christ the same yesterday and today and forever.
Ese ikejo Jesu Kristi okan na ni ni ana ati ni oni ati titi lai.
Verse 9, be not carried about with divers and strange doctrines, for it is a good thing that the heart be established with grace, not with meats which have not profited them that have been occupied therein.
Ese ikesan e ma se je ki a fi oniruru ati eko ajeji gba yin kiri nitori o dara ki a mu yin ni okan le nipa ore ofe ki se nipa onje ninu eyi ti awon ti o rin ninu won ko ni ere.
He's telling us that we should show gratitude. How do we show gratitude? One, he tells us, remember the people that are giving you the word of God.
O so fun wa pe a gbodo fi okan imore wa han. Bawo la si le fi okan imore wa han. Olosi wa so fun wa pe a gbodo ma ranti awon eni ti Olorun yan gege bi olori wa.
He says, remember them which have the rule over you.
O ni e ma ranti awon ti won je olori yin.
You have come into the family of God, you are a member of the church.
O ti wa sinu ebi Olorun, o si je omo ijo.
You are under control, you are under leadership, you are under a rule.
O wa la bi akoso, o wa la bi awon adari be
ni. Who are these people that have the rule over you? The people that have spoken the word of God unto you.
Awon wo ni won je alase lori re, awon na ni awon ti won ko ni oro Olorun.
What is your responsibility? You are to follow their faith, you are to follow their faithfulness.
Kini ojuse ti a wa nbere lowo re? Ojuse na ni pe o lati tele igbagbo won ki o si tele ijoloro won.
You are to consider, you are to meditate upon, you are to analyze the end, the purpose, the goal, the destiny of their conversation and life.
O si lati ma sasaro ko ma gba yewo ko ma wo awofin nipa igbe aye won ele to je po jasi ere
ko. Number one, there is something to remember.
Number
two, there is someone to rely upon.
He
says, see what he has done in the past. And
it's
still the same today, he will never change. He says, see the help he gave you in the past. And see the promise of companionship he has made unto you. He was faithful in the past, he is still faithful today. Why? Because Jesus Christ the same yesterday and today and forever.
Iwo na foju nu wa awon ileri ibanikegbepo ele to ti se fun o ni igbani idi re si ni pe tori pe Jesu Kristi bo ti je okan na lana okan na si ni loni okan na ni titi lai.
And so rely on him.
Nipa bayi o lati simi le.
Number 3 says, then you know that he has given us the word.
Eketa oni o je mo ti fun wa ni oro na.
And he has sent preachers of the word to teach you that you may observe to do all that he has commanded until the end of the world, then am I with you till the end of the world.
O si ti yan awon oniwasu lati ko ni oro na pe ki o ba le ma fi ekiti esi gbogbo awon nkan ti a ko e titi de ope aye emi yo si wa pelu e pelu re titi
gbogbo aye. And so it tells us, number 3, remain steadfast or movable in the truth and the doctrine of Christ.
O wa so fun wa ni idaketa wa yi pe o n lati duro gbegbe lai yese ninu eko Kristi.
Number 1, remember.
Akoko ranti.
Number 2, rely on Christ.
Ekeji simile Christi.
Number 3, remain steadfast in the truth and the doctrine of the word of God.
Eketa duro gbengbe lai yese ninu otito ati eko Christi.
That gives us the 3 points we are going to consider today in the study.
Eleyi lo fun wa ni oye awon koko meta ti a fe gba yewo nu eko.
Number 1, the desired submission of the saved.
Akoko oni ijowo ara eni atinu wa ti awon ti agbala.
He is talking to people that are born again. Because it tells us in verse 1, let brotherly love continue. When the family of God already, we are born again, we are saved, there must be desired submission of the saved.
Tori ko so fun wa ni ese ikini ori keta lai pe ki ife ara ki o wa titi iyen ni pe ati tun wa bi ati wa nu agbo Olorun ati wa nu ebi Olorun Torina, awa nreti ijo wa ara eni atinuwa ninu aye awon eni ta ti ra pada.
Number 2 is talking about a divine savior who is ever the same.
Ekeji o so nipa olugbala wa lati orun wa ti ki yi pada.
Number 3 is talking about doctrinal stability among the saints.
Eketa o ni ifese mule irere laarin awon eniyan mimo.
The stability of doctrine, the doctrinal stability among the saints. Let's look at it now from number 1. It tells us, remember them which have the rule over you. Who have spoken unto you the word of God. Whose faith follow and considering the end of their conversation. From the very beginning of time, the Lord has always sent his word through appointed, anointed servants of his to tell the people the mind of God. And he's still doing that today. And he's telling us that the responsibility of the leadership is to rule, is to control, is to direct, is to teach the word of God, is to speak the word of God, is to show an example of faith. And there is the responsibility also of the congregation listening to the preaching of the word.
Oni ojuse nti ayan gege bi adari oni lati ma sakoso lati ma dari awon eniyan lati fi oye oro olorun ye awon eniyan na ojuse awon ti won si n gbo oro olorun lenu adari yi oni lati le ma gboran si gbogbo awon nkan ti anti pasa adari ko.
The responsibility of the leader is very clear.
Ojuse ti adari o han kedere
is to be faithful to the Lord who has appointed him.
Is
to teach the word of God in its totality and entirety.
Is
to call sinners out of sin into repentance.
Is
to point to the Lord Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith.
Is
to remind the people of the promises of God so they can hold on to those promises and be saved and be established in their faith. And the leader is to work for the perfection of the saints, for the children of God.
It's
to rightly divide the word of truth.
It's
to preach the word in season and out of season. And
it's
to make sure that all the people that God has given him, he loses none, he takes them to the Lord on the final day. Says, these are the people you brought into the kingdom through my preaching. I prayed with them, I counseled them, I did everything, I fed them with the word of truth. Now I present them to you. That's the responsibility of the leadership, bringing the people to the
Lord.
But now the people themselves, like you now, the congregation, as you are sitting down listening, you have a responsibility.
It
says, remember them that have the rule over you. Number 1, understand that you are under leadership, you are under control, you are under ruling.
Akoko on lati maipe o wa labe akoso en to ndari o wa labe isakoso en ti o ndari
re. And then, who speak the word of God to you?
Awon ti won so oro Olorun fun
yin. That means that you are to listen to the word of God as the word of God is being spoken unto you.
Iyan ni pe on lati feti si oro Olorun gege bi a tin so oro Olorun fun.
Faith follow.
It's like
that's what they look at in their lives. Don't look at their grammar, their English, their vocabulary, their faith. Don't look at their physical peculiarities. The preachers will have some physical peculiarities.
Don't look at that. Look at their faith. Look at their faithfulness. Look at their fidelity.
Oh, ni ma wo abuda oni wasu. Tori pe oni wasu le ni abuda kan. Iyen ko ni aso pe ko wo bi ko se pe ko ma wo igbagbo won, ko wo ijoloto won ati
Is he speaking the word of God to you?
So soro Olorun fun o.
Is he leading you by the word of God?
So ndari re nipa oro Olorun.
Your responsibility is to remember him.
Ojuse re ni lati ma ranti won.
And follow his faith and faithfulness.
Ki o si ma to ipase igbagbo won ati ijoloto won.
And consider the end of their conversation.
Ki o ma ro opin ro iwaye won.
When it says end, we use the word end in two ways.
Nigba to so pe opin a lo gbolo opin yi ni ona
meji. For example, when you finish a job, that finishing point you call end.
Fun apere to ba bere ise kan to pari re, a ma n toka si iruse to pari e pe o ti fopin sise na.
But when you are going to a place, the destination you are going, we also call that destination, that place, end.
Nigba to ba si wa rin ajo lo bi kan, ibi to n lo yen gbo ba debe, o wa doko ire ajo nigba na.
Now he's talking about the end in that sense, the destination, the goal, the result, the purpose of their manner of life.
Tori na ohun to wa so nipa ti opin ta ka yi o ni opin igbe aye won ele to je pe o ja wo ko se.
Let us see what he's telling us in this verse.
Eje ki awon to so fun wa ni ese yi.
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 12 and verse 13.
Ninu Thessalonica kini ori karun ese ikeji lati iketa la.
1 Thessalonians 5, 12 and 13. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in the Lord, and the people that admonish you.
Thessalonica kini ori karun ese ikeji la sugbon awa nbe yin ara lati ma wo awon tin se laala laarin yin ti won si se olori yin ninu Oluwa ti won si nkilo fun yin.
Here he is telling us the same thing. He said you must know them.
Ni o so nkan na fun wa pe agbodo mo won.
That means recognize them.
Ye nipa lati da won mo.
They labor over you.
Awon ti won se laala lori re.
They sweat over you.
Awon ti won lagun nitori
re. They do everything over you so as to take you from earth and take you to heaven. Know them, recognize them. Hebrews 13:7 one says remember them.
Iru awon to je pe won se laala pe ki won ba le mu o lati aye lo si ijoba Olorun o lati mo won ko da won mo eberu ori keta lese ikeje so o ni ki o ma ko ma wo won.
They are over you in the Lord. That means they are ruling over you, they are controlling you, they are directing you. You are not to be isolated, independent, autonomous. I will do whatever I like. If you are a member of the church, they are over you, they are ruling, they are controlling. Allow them to do what the Lord wants them to do for your life.
Awon ti o nse olori yin ninu Oluwa, awon ti won se olori ti won dari re, ti won sakoso re, ti won to sona, o kan gbodo je enikan so ti o ma darin boro okiri ninu ijo lai je pe o wa labi akoso. Tori na o gbodo daru awon ti won se laala lori
re. Verse 13 says that you should esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake.
Ni ese iketala o wa so ni ki esin ma bu ola fun won gidi gidi ninu ife nitori ise won.
Not because of their education, their work.
Ki se nitori iwe ti won mo bi ko se nitori ise won.
Not because they are handsome or ugly, their work.
Ki se tori pe won rewa tabi o bu rewa sugbon nitori ise won.
Not because you like them, because of their work.
Ki se pe tori po didi feran won sugbon nitori ise won.
Because they are doing a kind of work that Satan does not like.
Tori pe ise ti won se inu esu odo si.
They are doing a kind of work that the flesh is supposed to.
Tori won se iru ise to je pe eran ara ma ntako.
They are doing a kind of work that Jesus Christ died to accomplish on the cross of Calvary, and there are the people pointing you to Calvary, and there are the people pointing you to heaven, and there are the people doing the greatest thing anybody can do on earth for you, because they are laboring to take you from sin unto the Savior and lead you in the way of holiness and take you to heaven. Because of that, esteem them highly, very highly in love, because of the work they are doing.
Ise ti won se ise takun takun ni ise le to je pe o mu ki won ma toka re si Christi en to ku lori igi agbelebu lati fi eje re se tutu fun o ele to je pe ko si enikan to le se ru re ninu aye yi nitori ise takun takun ti won se yi an lati ma bu ola fun won gidi gidi ninu ife nitori ise won.
In 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 17.
Ninu Timothy ke ni ori karun ese iketa de logun.
Let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially they who labor in word and doctrine.
Awon alagba ti o se akoso dara dara ni ki a kaye si ola iloko meji pelu pelu awon ti o se laala ni oro ati ni ikoni.
Here we find the injunction, the instruction, the commandment of the word of God to you.
Ni o lati gbe ri ase Olorun.
He's saying there are elders. It's not talking about age in the literal sense.
He's
talking about the people that go before you and you follow after.
He's
talking about the people that are leading and you follow them.
He's
talking about the people that go to the throne of grace and the presence of God, and they bring the bread of life and they bring it unto you and then you eat.
O so nipa ru awon ti won lo siwaju ite ori ofe ti won o gba onje iye nibe ti won o si se ipe fun nu re
po. Count them worthy of double honor.
Oni ru awon eni be ki a ka won ye si ola iloko meji.
What is he telling us? He says, if you are a Christian, if you are working in an office, if you are working somewhere, if you are a real Christian, you will honor that boss, you will honor that director, you will honor that manager, you will honor that leader in the secular sense. Now we come to the church, the people that labor in word and doctrine, that teach you the word of the Almighty God and make you to know what will be profitable for you for eternal life, you will give them not the ordinary honor, not just the one level honor, you double it and then you give them double honor because of the labor they have upon you to lead you to the Lord.
Awon ti won je giwa ile ise tabi awon alakoso ile ise na o niru ola to ma nfuru awon eniyan be nitori ipo won ni bi ise o wa so pe nipa ti emi awon ti won je oluko ni awon alagba ninu ijo Olorun awon ti won se laala nipa oro ati iko ni oro Olorun iru ola de ti a fi fun awon giwa ile ise an lati so di iloko meji lati fi ru re furu awon adari be.
So in Hebrews chapter 13 verse 7,
nitori na ninu Hebrews ori ketala ese keje,
remember them which have the rule over you.
O ni e ma ranti awon ti won je olori yin.
Can I remind you that this is not an advice, this is a commandment of the Lord.
Mba je ro leti pe eleki ise imoran sugbon eleyi je ase lati odo Oluwa.
The evidence that you are born again is that you are obedient to the commandment of the Lord.
Ami po si wa ti di atobi ni pe wa je olugboran si ase Olorun.
You forget about how you feel, you forget about what the person has done apart from preaching the word. Look at the preaching of the word, the centrality of the ministry he has towards you. Because of that, obey the word of God. Remember them that have the rule over you, who have spoken unto you the word of the Lord, whose faith follow, considering the end of their conversation.
Eleyo tumo si iru imolara to ba ni tabi iru awon kankan to ba n fi oju bintinu aye eni to n ko Olorun Olorun isugbon ase oro Olorun so wi pe ki o ma ran ti awon ti won je olori yin ti won ti so oro Olorun fun yin.
When it says remember, what does that mean? It means you should respect them, esteem them, love them. It means you should obey their spiritual authority and leadership. When it says remember them, it means remember them with thanksgiving unto the Lord. You remember them, not just remembering their facial appearance, remembering how they look physically. You remember them and you remember the word they are teaching you. You remember the doctrine they are teaching you. You remember the spiritual influence they have upon your life. Because of that, you remember them with thanksgiving unto the Lord.
You
remember them, you speak well of them when they are behind them, and of course when you are in their presence, you remember them to the point that you remember those good things that they have done towards you, how you came out of darkness, how you are delivered, how you are healed, how you have been blessed. And when you remember them, you speak well of them. That's how to remember them.
Ti oro Olorun so pe ki a ma ran ti won Ohun ti oro Olorun tun so nipa riranti won ni pe an lati ma ranti won si rere ka ma soro rere nipa won boya ngba ta ba wa leyin won ni tabi ngba ta ba ri won loju koroju an lati ma ranti won ka si ma soro rere pa won tori pe Olorun ti lo won lati ja si orisun ibukun fun wa nipa mimu wa jade kuro nu okokun.
You remember them by putting into practice the teaching they have given to you.
Ohun lati ranti won nipa fifi awon eko ti a ti ko si ojuse nipa se won.
You treasure the instruction they have given you in your heart.
Ki o mu eko
you remember, you call to mind their exhortation, their warning, their counsels unto you.
You
remember, you constantly meditate upon the truth you have received from them. It says, remember them which have the rule over you, who have spoken unto you the word of God, whose faith follow.
Only a man ranti awon ti se olori yin ti won ti so oro Olorun fun yin ki e si ma ro opero iwaye won.
The word of faith in the original Greek could have been translated whose faithfulness follow.
Gbọlọrun ti a pe ni igbagbo ni igbe aye igbagbo gege bi a se tumo re ni ede Greek gan o ni ijoloto
won. And that is, they themselves are following and they are practicing what they are teaching. They are very faithful to the Lord, they are faithful to the word of God, they are faithful to you as well, teaching you every time, even when they are weak physically, even when they could have given excuses, I cannot do that now because of my physical condition. They are faithful unto you and they are laboring over you. You also, you will follow their faith, fidelity, and faithfulness.
Igbagbo won on taka si ijoloto won nipa jije oloto si Oluwa nipa jije oloto si awa ti won ko nipa jije oloto si eko oro Olorun ti a fi nko wa pe awon gan papa n fi si ojuse nipa jije oloto pe bo tile je pe o re won ti agara da won won o ni bikita nipa agara to da won isugbon won a tesiwaju lati ma na o
ti ko Olorun. You should always consider the end of their conversation.
Oni ki a si ma ro pe ro igbe aye won.
That means you are considering the purpose of their teaching. You are considering the goal of their teaching. You are considering the very end and the destiny it will lead you to. You are considering the result of what they are doing, their own life, the application of the doctrine in their life, in their family, everything they do. As you are obeying that word of God they are teaching you, you consider, you meditate upon, you plan your life on the very fact that it is okay for them, the goal, the purpose, the destiny, that that's what is leading them to. It's actually very good. You consider that and you follow after.
Wa ma gba gbogbo awon eko won yi ro ele ti won fi nko nipa yi pe o me pe bi eko yan se igbesi aye awon fura won lanfani ti won nko ni be ni yo se awon na lanfani a ma wo ilepa ati ohun ti yo je ete pari pari awon eko na nipa titele ati nipa se afarawe won.
Now we know that Paul the apostle wrote Hebrews, the epistle to the Hebrews.
A mo wi pe awon eberu ni Paul apostle ko episteli yi si.
And see how he was serious about following your leader, obeying your leader, respecting your leader, honoring your leader, loving your leader. The question is, would Jesus Christ say the same thing?
Nigba ti a si wa wo awofin bi Paul se ntenu mo bi o se se pataki fun wa lati le teriba fun awon adari lati le feran awon adari lati ma ro opin ro igbe aye won bi Paul se tenu mo je be na ni Jesu Oluwa tenu mo nigba aye re bi.
Look at Matthew chapter 10.
Iwo wo Matthew ori kewa.
In Matthew chapter 10 we're looking at verse 40.
Ninu Matthew ori kewa wo ese ogoji ni be.
I need to remind you that this was the time that Jesus sent out the 12 disciples.
Mo lati ran leti pe akoko gan ni ti Jesu ran awon omo eyin re meji meji.
And these 12 disciples, like Peter, like James, like John, like Andrew, like the rest of them, they still had some things that Jesus Christ himself knew he needed to do in their lives.
Awon omo eyin Jesu ti a ran jade ibi Peteru, Anderu, Joanu ati bebe gbogbo won won si ni ohun kan ti Jesu lati se ninu aye won.
And therefore the people might have looked at them and said, if Jesus came to us directly and preached the word of God to us directly, we will obey, we will honor him, we will do everything he wants us to do. But Peter of all people, James of all people, and the sons of thunder of all people, we know them. Because of what we know about them, we can't totally respect them like that, like we would have respected the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen to the words of the Lord.
Awon eniyan le wo won ti kategbin yin awon me yin Jesu Oluwa ko so pe ba se pe Jesu lo to wa to wa wa soro olorun fun wa ni taara abati e bola fun abati e tewo gba n to wi sugbon bo ba je pe ru peteru laarin gbogbo eniyan Jacob ati Joanu awon ma ara laarin gbogbo awon eyan awon ta mo duju ni won fe wa soro olorun fun wa ku won ma foju bintin won sugbon won ti Jesu Oluwa so
Matthew chapter 10 verse 40
no Matthew orika e wese ogoji
he that receives you receives me
oni eni ti o ba gba yin o gba mi
oh yes they are false but he sent them out of the world he said I give you the word and that word makes you so important to the people he that receiveth you receiveth me he that receiveth me receiveth him that sent me
lo to ni won le ni awon alebu ti a le ri pe ka ma toka si sugbon nitori pe a ti fi ise oro olorun ran won ise pataki oro olorun nu aye won o mu ki jesu oluwa so pe eni ti o ba gba yin o gba mi en ti o ba si gba mi o gba eni ti o ran mi
look at Luke chapter 10 and verse 16
iwa wo Luke orikewa ese ikerindinlogun
let me remind you that Luke chapter 10 we're looking at the 70 disciples that Jesus sent out they were of the lower level in leadership in authority in anointing in power lower level than the apostles of the Lord
o ye ki le ran leti pe ninu Luke orikewa yi ibe ni Jesu Oluwa ti gbe ran awon meyin re adorin jade nipa ti awon adorin ti aran jade yi won tun kere ninu ipo ati ninu agbara ti ase ju ti awon apostle lo
so see what you said about the 70
sugba iwo won to so nipa awon adorin yi
and now you begin to understand the importance of leadership and the importance of who a pastor to be the importance of who a coordinator is the importance of a leader in a local church
nipa wiwo awon nkan won yi yo wa je ko mo ise pataki ohun ti adari je iru ipo pataki ti oluṣagutan wa tabi iru ipo pataki ti adari ekun wa tabi awon ti a ba fi se adari ninu
ijo Luke chapter 10 verse 16
ninu Luke orike we se ikerin de logun
he that heareth you heareth me
eni ti o ba gbo ti yin o gbo ti emi
they were just the 70 disciples you remember
awon adorin omo eyin lele so ranti
in fact they were not yet sanctified you remember
o ti eje mo pe won o ti ni so di mimo abo ranti
in fact this was the first time they were going out do you remember that
o wa mo pe igba akoko ni ti won jade lo abo ranti
they were not baptized in the Holy Ghost yet do you remember that
o ti fi agbara mi mo kun abo ranti eleyi
but he gave them the word
sugbo fun won ni oro na
he said go to the lordship of the house of Israel
o ni eto awon agutan ile Israeli to
so no tell them the word of repentance
ki e si lo soro ironu ku wada fun
he that heareth you heareth me
o ni en ti o ba si gbo ti yin o gbo ti emi
he that despises you despises me
eni ti o ba si ko yin o ko mi
oh you know sometimes our attitude well, I believe the Lord I honor the Lord I respect Jesus Christ I believe Jesus Christ is that coordinator that I don't respect I know too much of him I cannot respect that man
o mo iru wa si ta ma nwu gba mi a so pe a bo ba se pe to olorun ni mo mo e olorun olorun ye ni ola o ye ni iye o e be ni Jesu Christ ye ni en ta agbega sugbon se coordinator adari ekun yen mo mo ju ba wa adari gan se mo ni yi lo
I have been long in the church I know the pastor very much I know his weaknesses I know his shortcoming I know the things he does that I don't like. I love Jesus. I respect Jesus. I will obey the Lord. I will take it if the Lord were to do that. But as for the pastor, I know what I take. I know what I don't take. I know how to deal with him. My friend, look at the word of God. He that heareth you, heareth me. He that despises you, despises me.
Mama, olùṣọ́àgùtà dáadáa torí mo ti pẹ́ nù ìjọ. Ati pe gbogbo awon alebu ati abuku ati ailera oluṣagutan mo mo to ba je pe olorun lo pase yen fun mi mo mo pe olorun lo pa to ba je pe jesu lo soro yen ni ma di mu lokunkundun sugbon tori pa ati pe nu ijo yi bo ba oluṣagutan ba so nkan mi mo le ma gbagbo iwo wo ntoro olorun wi ore mi o ni en ti o ba gbo ti yin o gbo ti emi en ti o ba si ko yin o ko mi
and he that despises me despises him that sent me
o ni en ti o ba si ko mi o ko eni ti o ran mi
I pray God will bring us back to the scriptures
mo gbadura ki Oluwa mu wa pada sinu iwe mimo
Hebrews chapter 13
Eberu ori ketala
verse 17
ese iketa de lobo
obey them that have the rule over you and submit yourselves
e ma gbo ti awon ti nse olori yin ke si ma te ri
bapo that's the commandment of the Lord
ele ni ase Oluwa
I'm not the one that wrote that there
emi ko ni mo ko ere
si I'm not the one that appointed myself as a leader in this church
ki se emi lo yin ara emi ke
obey them that have the rule over you and submit yourselves
e ma gbo ti awon ti for
they watch over your soul. They watch for your soul. As they that must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that's unprofitable for you. We go to point number two. He's telling us in point number two, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. Why is he bringing that up? He's saying that what you have learned now in verse 7 is what he said when he was in his earthly ministry. And he told the people directly, he that heareth you, heareth me. And then he says, don't think he has changed. He remains of the same conviction. He is saying the same thing today. Because Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever.
Nigba to wa ninu aye to nsise iranse ase kan na to pa fun awon eniyan ni igba ni o kan sun na lo npa ni lowo lowo bayi tori pe Jesu Christi okan na ni lana loni ati titi lai.
If you remember what we have been studying in the book of the Hebrews,
ti o ba ti ranti awon nkan ta ti ko nu iwe Hebrew,
the epistle had been teaching us that the old covenant has been taken away to bring in the new covenant.
Epistle yi fi han wa gbangba wi pe majamu lai lai o lati pare kuro ti a si mu to
to
wonu,
that the old covenant had to be changed,
ipe a lati paro majamu lai lai,
that the temple of the old covenant has been destroyed,
wi pe ati wo temple
the ceremonial law had been abolished. The Levitical priesthood has been removed. And now we have a new covenant. And so the people that were reading the epistle to the Hebrews, they were thinking, well, the temple has been removed, the old covenant has been abolished, all the ceremonial law has been taken away. Maybe what we have now also will be taken away sometimes, and a better thing will still come.
Gbogbo awon ilana irubo ati ofin atowodowo igba na o la ti mu kuro nbe be si ni temple igba ye ti awon eniyan wonu re lati lo josi lati wo lule ele ti won so ini isin boya ngbo baya won wo paro ye
na. So he studied us that this is a better covenant, this is a new covenant, is a final covenant, is a permanent covenant, because the head and the one that established that covenant, he remains ever the same Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever.
O wa nfidi re mule pe ti a ba roru nkan be yen ka ma se ro rara tori pe majamu titun yi o ni majamu to dara ju en ti se alarina re o lo ga ju be si ni a ti fidi re mule tori pe Jesu Christi okan na ni lana loni ati titi lai lai.
He was saying, if you consider the old covenant, you consider the priests, they were changing and changing from Eli unto Eliezer, from Eliezer unto another high priest, from that one unto Eli. It was changing, but this our great high priest will never change. He is Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today and forever.
Only to pass the gap when the party or Yolori Alufati, one month in Jenny, like Israel, in it. He said, Yaman Paro, Nibatika Bati, Besse, I'm well, I'm off your parole. Latori Raroni, Obasori, Eliaseri, Latori Eliaseri, Otto Quajasori, Eli. So what about Japan Patio, Lori Alufa, what you know, Maja Mutito Yini, Jesu Christi, or Kanani Lana, Lonia, as it's like.
He says, you consider the prophetic system in the Old Testament. There was Samuel, and then there was Elijah, there was Elisha, and all those prophets were being changed as they finished their term. But he says concerning our own prophet, when he said, I will send another one unto you like unto Moses, he remains the same Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today and forever.
O so pe to ba je pe npa ti se iranse awon woli ninu majamu lai lai ni bi kan tin pari ise iranse re tin file sa so bora bi aso be ni elomiran to n gba ise iranse ba ti ri ninu aye iru awon eniyan bi Elijah ati Elisha ati Samuel nigba won pari ise iranse won won re koja lo sugba ninu ileri Olorun wipe emi yo gbe woli kan dide fun yin eni ti o wa titi ni tori pe woli agba ni eni ti o ma wa titi tori pe Jesu Christ okan na ni lana loni ati titi lai lai.
So you consider the kings of Israel as you had Saul, you had David, then you had Solomon, then you had the people that followed. He said they were being changed, but as for this king and for this king of kings and lord of lords, he remains the same. He's the everlasting eternal king. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever.
Ohun to ba si je pe ka ronu pa tawon oba tin je ni ile Israel ni bi Saul ti je oba to lo igba ti etan be ni David tu gori oye leyin igba na ohun la to fi Solomon joba gbogbo won bi o tin ku be la nparo won sugbon to ba je pe pa ti Jesu Christi ni o ni oba awon obo Oluwa awon Oluwa tori pe Jesu Christi okan na ni lana loni ati titi lae.
He says you should consider three things about him.
O ni ko gba awon nkan meta ro ni
pa. Number 1 is divine personality.
Akoko o ni bi o se je eni ti orun
eternal
eni aye raye
immutable
eni ti ko le yi pada
omnipotent
eni ti o ni agbara julo
every time always all those qualities about Christ they are ever the same. Therefore Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever.
Gbogbo awon amuye ati ipo agbara to wa nu Christi yi bakan na lori tori pe Jesu Christi ki yi pada o ni kan na ni lana loni ati titi lai.
Number 2 consider his office
bakan na ko tu wo ipo re nipa ti
office
gege bi alufa
as a prophet
gege bi woli
as a king
gege bi oba
lord and savior
oluwa ati olugbada
he remains ever the same
bakan na lori
his dominion will never end
ijoba re ko ni nipe
ko his authority remains the same
ase re bakan na ni
his revelation teaching doctrine remains the same
awon aso tele re bakan na lori
Jesus Christ the same yesterday and today and forever
Jesu Christi okan na ni liana ati ni oni ati titi lai.
Number 3 consider his relationship sheep to the church.
Iketa iwo wo ibasepo re pelu ijo.
Number 1 as the mighty savior.
Akoko gege bi olugbala nla.
He forgave sins when he was on earth. He's still forgiving sins today. Why? Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever.
O dari ese gini nigba to wa nu aye yi. O si tun dari gini lowo lowo bayi. Tori pe kini Jesu Kristi okan na ni lana loni ati.
Number 2 as the powerful shepherd of the sheep.
Ekeji gege bi olusu aguta lori awon aguta
re. All the sheep that my father has given me, I cannot lose any of them, because he says no one is able to pluck them out of my hand. He has the power to keep you if you are willing to be kept, because Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever.
O so ninu gbolohun oro re pe gbogbo awon agutan ti baba mi ti ko fun mi ko si enikeni to le ja kankan gba ninu won lowo mi ti iwo ba nfe pe ki o le pa omo titi do pe tori kini tori pe o ni agbara lati pa omo okan na ni lana loni ati titi lai.
Number 3 as an effectual intercessor. He is interceding for us as he interceded for Peter, and Peter was restored, as he interceded for the church from the beginning. He is still interceding today. He has not changed. He is still pleading for mercy on your behalf, because Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever. Forever he remains faithful interceding for you.
Eketa gege bi asipe to munadoko bo se sipe fun Peteru nigba to pada seyin ti Peteru fi pada wa sinu agbo be na lo nsipe fun ijo Olorun lati iwase wa bakan na lo si nsipe fun iwo ati emi loni nitori pe kini o ni asipe to munadoko tori pe okan na ni lana loni ati titi lai.
As sanctifier
gege bi en tin so ni
bi mimo the same
bakan na ni
as a baptizer and the Holy Ghost
gege bi en to fi agbara emi mo
kun ni as a great physician
gege bi oluwosan
la as a great deliverer
gege bi oludari
as a lord of lords and a king of kings
gege bi oluwa awon oluwa oba awon ba
he ever was, he is today.
Ti je ni igba ni be na lori loni
the all sufficient savior
o ni olugbala ato gbogbo se
and so he tells us Jesus Christ the same yesterday and today and forever.
Nipa bayi lo se nso fun wa pe Jesu Christi okan na ni lana loni ati titi lai.
In Hebrews chapter 1 verse 12
ninu eberu ori kini ese ikejila
Hebrews chapter 1 verse 12 and as a vesture shall thou fold them up and they shall be changed, but thou at the same, thy years shall not fail.
Eberu ori kini ese ikejila ati bi aso ni iwo si ka won a o si paro won sugbon bakan na ni iwo odun re ki o si pe.
Psalm 102 verse 27
orin Davidi orin 102 ese iketa de lo
Psalm 102 verse 27. But thou art the same, thy years shall have no end. You will see that as he's talking about God Almighty the Father, he's talking about Jesus Christ, because he says, I and my Father are one. The same, he changes not. Revelation chapter 1:8. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, says the Lord, which is, and which was, and which is to come, the Almighty.
Only a mini Alpha at Omega, if we let say at your when you look are we and it's your be Tiotiwa.
And so you see that Jesus Christ remains ever the same. And his love is available for you today. His grace is available for you today. His mercy and compassion available for you today. He's ever the same. Anything you could have got from him when he was on earth, you can get from him today. You come to him with the same confidence that those people came to him, because Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Hebrews chapter 13:9.
Now, he tells us about the stability of the Lord, the consistency of the Lord in verse 8. What's the consequence of that? If the master is stable and established and steadfast, what happens to his disciple?
If
the head of the church changes not, what happens to the church? If Jesus Christ, your Savior, your Lord, your Master, if he remains fixed, established, unmovable, how about you? What's going to do to be your attitude?
Ti Jesu Christi and ti se Oluwa ati Olugbala re to ba duro gbangban ti o yese ti ko si nkan kan to le mi kini yo wa je igbagbo iwo to gbagbo.
In Hebrews chapter 13:9.
Eberu ori keta le ese ikesan.
Be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines.
E ma se je ki a fi oniruru eko ati ajeji gba yin kiri.
That's a consequence of what we read in verse 8.
Eleyi ni abajade o ta ka ni ese ikejo.
Jesus remains the same.
Bakan na ni Jesus se wa titi
doni. The new covenant is final.
His
love is final.
His
doctrine remains the same.
He
does not change, therefore you should not change. Be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines. You will see that every time in the New Testament, when false doctrines are referred to, it's in the plural. When you are referring to the doctrine of the Lord, it's the singular as a unit. One teaching, one truth, one doctrine, one Lord, one baptism. And so don't be carried about by all those different kinds of doctrines and strange doctrines. In Ephesians 4:14. That we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and the cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive.
Ti ti a si fin gba kiri nipa itoje eniyan nipa rekereke fun ogbon kogbon ti mu ni sina.
Is calling for doctrinal stability.
O npe wa si duro sisin nu eko.
Please be stable.
Oni ko duro gbangba.
The Lord is stable, you are a disciple, be stable.
Oni Oluwa re o duro gbangba iwo gege bi omo eyin re o lati duro gbangba.
You've known the Lord for some years now, don't be like a child that has been still been tossed to and fro. Remain steadfast in the things of the Lord, be stable.
O ti mo Oluwa fun opo odun seyin ma se dabi omo kekere tan ti sibiti sorun sugbon o ti mo otito oro Olorun duro ni otito ta ti fun o.
In Romans chapter 16 verse 17.
Ninu Romu orikarindinlogun ese iketa
de. Now I beseech you brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them.
Ara emi si beyin e ma so awon ti se iyapa ati awon ti mu ohun ikose wa lodi si eko ti eyin ti ko e si kuro ni so won.
He says you should mark them, they cause division, they cause offenses contrary to the doctrine, the totality, the entirety, the unity of the doctrine that you have learned, avoid them.
O ni e ma so awon ti o se iyapa awon ti o mu ohun ikose lodi si eko to ye koro wa iru awon eniyan be e kuro ni so won.
In 1 Timothy chapter 6.
Ninu Timothy kini ori kefa.
Reading from verse 3.
Anka ese iketa.
If any man teach otherwise and consent not to hold some words, even to the words of our Lord Jesus Christ and to the doctrine which is according to godliness.
Bi enikeni ba nko ni eko miran ti ko si gba oro ti o ye ko ro ani oro Jesu Kristi Oluwa wa ati eko gege bi iwa bi Olorun.
Anybody that is bringing any other strange doctrine, diverse kinds of doctrines, he is proud, knowing nothing, but doting about questions and strifes of words, whereof cometh envy and strife and railings and evil surmises.
Enikeni ele to ba mu awon eko ajeje wa ti ru eni be o si fe teri ba fun eko oro Olorun eni be o gberaga ko mo nkan kan bi ko se ife iyan jija ati ija oro ninu eyi ti lara iya oro buburu ati iro buburu ti wa.
In verse 5, perverse disputings of men of corrupt minds, destitute of the truth, supposing that gain is godliness, from such withdraw thyself.
Ese ikarun oro ayipo awon lokan eri ti ko si otito ninu won ti won se bi ona si ere ni iwa bi Olorun. Yera lodo iru awon won ni.
He says don't be close to them, don't be intimate with them, don't make them your intimate friend, withdraw yourself from them.
Oni gbogbo iru awon ti won ni ru asa be ma so mo won ma yan won ni ore kori koso iru awon eni be se ni ko yera fun won.
Don't get their bottle of oil to go and be anointing people, don't get their cassette to go and be listening to, don't get their literature. You know that they are preaching strange doctrine, erroneous doctrine, something not founded on the scriptures, not grounded in the truth. He says you should withdraw yourself from there.
Magba igororo lowo oru awon eyan be ko wa lo ma ta lawon eyan lori. Be si ni o gbodo gba iwe ilewo tabi iru cassette ta li si gba oro Olorun won si ti lati ma lo gbo. Oni ru awon eyan be ma se ni ajose kokan pelu won sugbon yera kuro lodo oru awon
eyan. Because Jesus Christ is the same, is stable, is steadfast, established. Because of that, you should not be unstable in doctrine.
O so eleyi fun wa tori pe Jesu en ti se apere igbagbo wa o duro gbangba ko ma sasibi sasorun tori na lati wo awokose re ki awa na si mu duro gbangba.
Christ is the same teacher, his doctrine does not vary, he does not fluctuate, and his purpose does not change. Therefore we who are the disciples of the Lord and the children of God saved by the precious blood of the Lamb, we shall remain steadfast in the truth.
Christ je oluko ni sibe eko re ko yato ife re pelu ki se dakudaji sugbon bi o se nko ni igba ni bakan so na lo nko ni titi di oni asin lati duro ninu otito na.
It means we submit to his will.
Ye ni pe an lati teri ba fun ife re.
We abide in us his unchanging doctrine.
A ma duro gbangba ninu eko re ti kini pada.
And we obey his word in all things.
A si je eni to n gboran si oro re ninu gbogbo.
It is very important for you and I to know that Christian doctrine does not vary from day to day, because Jesus Christ is ever the same.
O ye ko le ye gbogbo wa wipe eko Christiani ki yato lati ojo di ojo nitori pe Jesu Christi okan na ni titi lai.
The truth is fixed.
Atifi, Dio ti ton mule.
What was true yesterday is still true today, will be true tomorrow.
On to jo ti ton lana, on kan na lo ti ton ato ni, be ni yo ma jo ti ton lola.
The gospel is unchanging.
Irere yi si je eti ko le yi pada.
Christ remains the same in his will, in his word.
Christ si wa bakan na ninu ife re ati ninu oro re.
Because of that, you must resolutely refuse to be led away by those who are teaching anything, any other thing.
Tori na on lo se lati se ipinu lati ri pe o ta ko gbogbo ru awon ti o ba nko ni ni eko miran.
And you must fortify yourself against the truth and persevere unto the very end in this same doctrine that God has given us in the word of God.
Asigbodo fi o di abo yi ara wa ka lodi si awon oluko ni eke ki a si fi aya ran titi di ope ninu otito oro Olorun ta ti fi ko wa yi.
If you are going to live eternally with God, you must be securely anchored in Christ.
Ti o ba gbe ni aye laye pelu Olorun o gbodo ni idakoro re ninu Kristi.
With an established heart rooted and grounded in the truth of the word of God.
Ki a si ni okan ti o fese mole ti o si fi gbogbo mole gbe gbe ninu oro Olorun.
Hebrews 13:9.
Ninu Hebrews orikata lese ikesan.
Be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines.
E ma se je ki a fi oniruru ati eko ajeji
sa ikiri. For it is a good thing that the heart be established with grace.
Nitori o da
and not with meat that's going back to the old covenant, not with meat that's going back to eating those sacrifices of the old covenant, not with meat which have not profited them that have been occupied therein.
Ki se nipa onje iyen ni pe pe pa pe pada sinu majemu lai lai. Ki se nipa onje ki se nipa pe pada sinu awon eran ti a fi ru bonu majemu lai lai ninu eyi ti awon ti o rin ninu won ko ni ere.
That's a challenge the Lord is giving you and giving to me.
Ipenija kan niyi ti Olorun fi fun iwa ati
emi. Proverbs chapter 23 verse 23.
Ninu iwe owe orikatalelogun ese iketalelogun.
Proverbs 23 verse 23.
Owe orikatalelogun ese iketalelogun.
Buy the truth and sell it not.
Ra otito ki o ma se ta.
Buy the truth and sell it not.
Ra otito ki o ma se ta.
And wisdom and instruction and understanding.
Ogbon pelu ati eko ati imoye.
By the grace of God, you have got that truth.
Nipa ore ofe Olorun o ti gba otito yi.
You will not sell it.
O ni ta.
You will not give it up.
O ni sonu.
You will not throw it away.
O ni sonu.
You will not play with the truth of the word of God in Jesus' name.
O ni fi owo yepere mu otito oro Olorun loruko Jesu.
We thank God for those of us who are here. You've been here, some of you, 15 years, 20 years. And I still see you coming to the Bible study. You still love the word of God. And you are still obeying the word of God. The Lord who has kept you all these 20 years or more. If Jesus tarries and you are still to spend another 20 years, God will keep you faithful.
Adupe lowo Olorun fun opolopo wa eto je pe bi ogun odun tabi odun medogun seyin on lati wa si eko bibeli ta sto n tesi waju titi di sisin yi Olorun to pa wa mo lati bi ogun odun seyin ti o ba si je pe a ni ogun odun mi lati lo si Olorun kan na yo pa wa mo ni oruko Jesu.
For those of us who have just come 1 year or 2 years who have just come, if you look around you, those who are sitting on the same bench, it's likely you'll find somebody there. He's been there for 10 years, God is keeping him. He's been there for 15 years, 20 years, God is keeping him. The same God that has kept that neighbor, that fellow brother, that fellow sister, that same God that helped them will help you and make you stable in the word of God in Jesus' name.
Fún àwọn tí wọ́n ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ dé sáàrin wa bóyá láti bí ọdún kan sísìn tó ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní wá sínú ẹ̀kọ́ bíbélì tó bá wo orí àga tó jókòó sí yẹn, ó ṣeéṣe kó o rí àwọn kan tó jẹ́ pé láti bí ọdún mẹ́wàá, ọdún mẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́dógún tàbí ogún ọdún ni wọ́n ti ń wá. Olorun to pa awon yen mo o lagbara lati pa iwo na mo yo si pa omo dokun ni oruko Jesu.
We will stay with the word of God.
I'll draw to oro Olorun.
Come what may, we're going to stay with the word of God.
O ko yewu to ba le de, I'll draw to oro Olorun.
If you have mind and you are united with us here, why don't you stand up and let us make a covenant together with the Lord? We know the Lord remains the same yesterday, today and forever. We will not change. We will hold on to this thing. We will dig deep. We'll be rooted in the truth. We'll be grounded in the truth. Nothing will blow us away from the truth. Open your mouth. fast and tell the Lord, I will never leave the truth. It has done well in my life. I've been saved. I've been sanctified. I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost. In this church I married. In this church I have children. In this church I got work. In the church the Lord has blessed me and promoted me. This word of God that has blessed my life, I will never leave it. It will be with me until I see the Lord face to face in the final day. This is what the Lord has sent you to make your life better. To prepare you for heaven. To keep your name in the book of life. And the devil is fighting against your life. The precious gift, the word of God that he has given you, the devil wants to take it away. And those false people, those deceivers, they are coming to you, they are smiling. They say they love you and they want to take the precious gift of God away from your life. Make a covenant to the Lord. I'll be rooted in the truth. I'll be grounded in the truth. I will never look to any other side. I will not mix with the people that are giving to change all my heart, all my soul, everything I've got. I will hold on to the word of God. My heart is fixed.
Lati fe fi ogbe ewe gba orere ti Olorun fi sinu aye re iwo ni wa se ipinu pe Oluwa okan mi ti mura gbogbo on to ba fe gba otito ikuro lowo mi won yera kuro lodo won yeba kuro ninu re ko muduro re ninu Olorun ko si duro gbengbe laiyese ninu eko Kristi.
They want to take Jesus away from you and give you oil in the bottle. They want to take Jesus away and give you water. They want to take Jesus away from you and give you incense and give you old covenant and give you the things that will not profit you. You say no, I'm going to follow the Lord till the very end. Nothing will make me to be swept away from my feet. I stand here, I will never move away from the
truth. Gbogbo awon nkan ti o lere awon nkan tinu majamu lai lai iwo lo ni fi aye gba won iwo lo ma muduro lai pe o bo ba se pe ti temi ni emi yo duro ti eko oro olorun won ni fi aye gba awon alayida yida lati mu mi kuro loju ona na.
Fellow brother, fellow sister, he has saved you. You have been faithful now for 5 years, for 10 years, for 20 years, for 25 years, for 30 years. Remain. Don't allow the devil to spoil your Christian life because of 1 year that remains, 2 years that remain, 5 years that remain, or whatever number of years remain before the Lord will come. As the Lord has helped you in the past, for all these many years, remain faithful. The Lord will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Iwọn abọdun die to ku niwaju re ti wa loyi ise lo ya ko muduro re ko ma se fi aye gba satani lati mu o kuro ninu igbagbo oni lati duro gbengbe ninu eko oro olorun gbogbo awon ayidayida awon nkan to le fe mu o kuro ninu igbagbo ma se fi aye gba muduro re ko tesiwaju titi dope oluwa oni pa de.
Thank you.